that an art exhibition actually is about what you can see. Not what you think in your brain, or not what your heart says. I mean, they're all very important. But what actually can you see with your eyes?
Perception
of the image that is different.
I can see, Cole.
The most beautiful. And can you just say a couple of things about what was happening for you as you painted it?
I had been dealing with the phenomenon, if I can call it like that, of ambiguity, and also a phenomenon of juxtaposition, if not confrontation, of different worlds. So here we have the deliberately copied the icon of Saint Luke, painting the original painting, Holy Mary with Child Jesus. And then I wanted to juxtapose it in a way that he now stands in front of crucifixion himself, painting the crucifixion, yet the point of the story is that his rendition is different from what he sees. That is the allusion to the not only Rashomon story, but also to the four Gospels that were not all identical in the rendition of Christian drama. The juxtaposition of different worlds, traditional, old, archetypal, new, chaotic, contemporary, modern, whatever. that's why the different methodology, the different techniques. This is the egg tempera with gold, typically iconic. This is done with just modern contemporary things, painted with black Japan and all this. Now, the frame is deliberately fragmented. It is the allusion to the fragmentary nature of our lives, of life itself. Fragmentary in a sense, day, night, birth, death, things like that. Within that fragmentation, we go back to the allusion to the iconographic symbolism, red for the divine, among other things, resurrection, also death as well, and the blue or green, dark in any way, for the human nature of Christ, divine nature of Christ, human nature of Christ.
The stranger asked me what my country was. My country knows no exile, no abroad, I told her. My country is anywhere I meet a stranger, I can share friendship and love with. My country is an idea flowing with light. It is not bound to a flag or a piece of earth I've left behind the tranquil motherlands. To those grown used to and settled there, I raced the winds to every horizon. The winds and I have sworn companionship.
I took just Christ thought, the cross out of that context, so reproduced it as faithful as I could, and then was always fascinated by that painting, The Battle of San Romano by Paolo Cello, kind of 15th, 16th century. Okay. So riders, you know, on horses, lances, that type of thing. So that painting is very, one of the great paintings, and very sculptural, very graphic, wherein the painter meticulously worried about the position of lenses and stuff like that. So again, I didn't know how can I possibly bring together things that I like in a new hybrid that I would sign. So suddenly I said, this is it. Let's put Christ on the cross and put the lenses exactly in the same direction, or even with same colors that the riders had in that painting. Paint, and the rest can be again the experiments, exploration, and expansion in gold. This is a Dutch gold, distressed gold, and this is like a pure gold, but different golds. You see, red gold, and 23 carats gold, subtle, very subtle differentiations. And just a few, like angels, like a few interventions with a little brush. I started playing with that particular figurine in my drawings and paintings, and that basically became my ever present Christ from the Crucifixion in the painting, so far at least, of the Crucifixion, because I never wanted to dwell on anatomical, photographic. Interesting artistically, apart from religious art and Christianity. If you kind of extrapolate this, if you just cut out this little segment, it would be like any abstract painting from some exhibition that people daily exhibit and gain great names or something like that. just because they look nice as paintings.
Yes, yes.
As plays with color or something. Mm. So that there is more to it than just crucifixion. I mean, there are other things as well. They are different in approach. Here we have graphic, aggressive, brash, horrific, destructive approach. And in the lower part, at the bottom, we have the solemnity, we have the aesthetic beauty that transcends the centuries, transcends the time in general. We can almost feel the whole idea would be that basically as I said, events like this, harmful, destructive events, but it is only through the Christian drama, through the death and the resurrection of Christ, that the mankind got the possibility of salvation.
I follow Michael's artwork a long time before. I followed him from a time from student time from Belgrade, from Academy of Fine Art. He always did very good job.